Hi everybody, we all know that Ethereum is one of the most popular cryptocurrency in the world. In just 6 years, Ethereum has acquired a market cap of more than $200 billion, and 99% of the people, including myself, had been so focused on its price that we completely missed out on the fact that the technology and application of Ethereum are so powerful that they can literally bring about a revolution as big as the internet. And just like the internet, they are also capable of giving rise to the next generation of super entrepreneurs. The question is, what is so special about Ethereum applications? And more importantly, how can people like you and me be a part of this blockchain revolution? And before we dive into it, I want to thank our partners for today's episode, and that is CoinSwitch. But more on this at the end of the video. On 3rd of September 2015, this heartbreaking image went viral on the internet. This is an image of a 3-year-old Syrian boy who tried to escape from Syria along with his family. He was one of the millions of Syrians who tried to escape Syria in order to take refuge in Greece. But in between, their boat collapsed and the entire family just drowned in the sea. When this story broke out, the world understood that it's not just about a picture, it is in fact a representation of the horrifying conditions of millions of refugees all across the world. Millions of refugees from countries like war-stricken Syria who are trying to seek asylum in Greece. Millions of refugees from countries like Venezuela, which is suffering from hyperinflation, wherein 1/10 of the entire population is trying to seek asylum in the rest of the world. And as of 2020, the world refugee population stood at 82.4 million individuals. And these are individuals who got forcibly displaced worldwide as a result of persecution, conflict, or human rights violation. And out of this humongous population, less than 5% will actually get asylum this year. And when they get asylum, most people think that their struggle ends. But you know what? It just gets started. Even after taking asylum in a particular country, the proof of identity takes weeks, sometimes even months to be processed. And since these people have to start from nothing, the government needs to provide special provisions just so that they can survive in the country. And here's where another problem arises. Most people don't get their documents at all. Some try to forge their documents and try to misuse the government's provision by forging their identity. And refugees don't get loans because the bank has no record of their past behaviors. And hence, it almost becomes impossible for a refugee to thrive in a new country. And in some countries, this reaches extreme levels. Now, I don't want to take the names of these countries, but here's where the identity of the refugees is purposefully destroyed just so that they can be forced into prostitution, child labor, and other horrific things that I cannot even explain. But you know what? There is one country wherein they are doing such an amazing job with refugee settlement that the refugees in this country are happier than the citizens of most countries. The question is, which country is this? And while even countries like US and Canada are struggling to tackle this issue of refugee settlement, how is this country able to handle this global issue so well? Well, the country that I'm talking about is Finland, and they are doing it by using a remarkable application of blockchain, which is something called smart contracts. For those who don't know, smart contracts are self-executing contracts with discrete terms of agreement between two parties. And this agreement is directly written into lines of code. And these contracts render transactions that are traceable, transparent, and irreversible. Now, in order to understand the application of smart contract, let's have a look at Finland. People, in 2015, Finland saw a rapid influx of refugees, and this influx was 10 times more as compared to 2014. And during this time, they were struggling to deal with refugee settlement. During this time, usually the government hands out cash disbursements, but in case of Finland, instead of the traditional cash disbursements, the Finnish Immigration Service partnered with a local startup called Moni. And this startup came out with the wonderful idea of a prepaid MasterCard. And this MasterCard was specially designed for asylum seekers who do not have a bank account. This card is linked to the unique digital identity stored on a blockchain, which is also in sync with the Finnish Immigration Services. And this turned out to be such an amazing solution that, let alone identity, this system literally works better than most of our traditional banks, wherein the accounts are not just accessible by smartphones, but also have an amazing feature to receive special government benefits and salary disbursements. And by bringing all the refugees officially into the banking system, Moni Services has enabled the asylum seekers to not just have an identity, but also to start contributing to the economy as soon as possible. Now, just to give you a better understanding of the system, let's take a very simple example. If John is an asylum seeker, then for the first year, if he is eligible for 30% subsidy in essential commodities and 5% subsidy for gas, and in the second year, if he is eligible for only 20% subsidy in essential commodities and 3% in gas, then automatically his MasterCard will get updated in such a way that when he goes to pay for his fuel using his MasterCard, he will automatically receive only 3% subsidy. And when he does the same for the grocery, for essential commodities specifically, he will get a 20% subsidy. And this smart contract could be so sophisticated that it can also put a limitation. That is, if John's income exceeds $10,000 for 3 months consecutively, then automatically the smart contract will revoke the subsidy because now John is rich and he no longer needs a subsidy. In addition, there is also a wonderful feature called the circle of trust. And the way this works is, if John borrows or lends money to his friends through his card, all of his transactions will get recorded and he will get a credit score. So if he consistently pays back all the loans that he's taken from his friends, the credit score of John will go up. At the same time, if he's like a conjuice and he doesn't pay back the money, then the credit score will go down. And all of this is documented on the blockchain and can be done at zero interest and without any extra charge. In this case, it becomes all the more amazing. Why? Because asylum seekers arrive at the new country with zero credit history. And this smart contract's calculation of credit score gets them in a position wherein they can borrow money from the financial institutions. And this is done with a vision that in the next 5 to 10 years, these very same asylum seekers should be in a position to go on to take loans so that they can go on to build businesses. And once these businesses start prospering, they can go on to become major contributors to the economy. And the best part is, everything, including the proof of identity, government subsidy access, credit scores, loans and salary disbursements, all of these processes are done on blockchain without a centralized system. And more importantly, with minimum human intervention, because of which there is no corruption. And guess what? These kind of case studies have become so amazing that now the European Union is planning to spend $2 billion into blockchain-based solution to solve the most pressing problems in the Europe. This is the power of Ethereum and smart contracts. Now let's talk about the most important segment of the video, and that is, how can you and I find business opportunities to participate in the blockchain revolution? And before we move on, I want to thank our wonderful partners CoinSwitch for supporting our content. CoinSwitch is a seamless application that enables you to buy and sell cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum in the easiest possible manner. And the one thing that I love about this application is, after downloading the application, it literally took me just 5 minutes to buy Bitcoin and Ethereum both. And this 5 minutes includes everything, starting from KYC, bank verification, all the way up to the final transaction. So let's say if you suddenly realize that the price of Bitcoin has fallen, by using CoinSwitch, even if you're not done with any formalities, within 300 seconds, you will be done with everything. So if you're a beginner crypto enthusiast, I would highly recommend you to use the CoinSwitch app. Before you invest, there are 3 things that I want you to take into consideration. Number one, do not consider crypto to be a get-rich-quick scheme. Number two, always keep an eye on the happenings around the world. And most importantly, my personal advice to you is, you should only invest as much as you can afford to lose. So tomorrow, let's say you decide to invest 1,000 rupees into crypto, your financial condition should be solid enough that tomorrow if you lose that money altogether, it should not affect your life in any way. If this is very, very clear to you, you can go on to download the CoinSwitch app from the link given below. And then you can go on to make your first crypto investment. Now let's talk about the 3 incredible applications of smart contract that can solve some of the most pressing issues in India. The first application is that of government subsidy allocation. People, in 2016, the Economic Survey of India revealed that about 1 lakh crore from the subsidy bill is being unevenly distributed to the better off population, as in the rich population. And this is due to the flawed targeting of the assistance. And this is caused due to multiple reasons, including corruption, fake documents, and most importantly, the lack of a technological tool that can calculatively allocate and revoke subsidies based on data. And my sense is, smart contract could be used to solve this problem. The second problem is that of fake documents. Now, fake documents is something that is widely used by people to make fake caste certificates. And using these certificates, they go on to claim 50,000 rupees in subsidy in college fees alone. And this is done by people who are pretty rich and do not need these subsidies to sustain. And moreover, as much as we need a system to filter out people who do not need subsidies, we also need a system that can revoke and allocate subsidies based on the progress that people make. For example, we need a system that can revoke a central government subsidy from a rich Mr. Chatterjee, whose income has now crossed a particular tax slab, and then allocate that subsidy to a Miss Patel in Gujarat who needs it because she's a single mother with two children who has recently lost her job. This is the ideal application of the smart contracts. And last and most importantly, my sense is India is witnessing a data management crisis. For example, in just 4 months into 2020, the Food Corporation of India had about 65 lakh tons of food grains wasted merely due to lack of storage. And at the same time, we had 189 million Indians sleeping hungry at night and had no access to food. And this is where corruption and lack of data processing systems end up putting millions of lives at stake in spite of the availability of resources. And here's where we need something more than just digitalization. And the answer to this problem could be blockchain and smart contracts. Now, this technology will come with its own share of problems, but I'm 100% sure that it will take us one step closer towards building a more democratic and a transparent system, eventually to go on to build a better India. That's all from my side for today, guys. If you learned something valuable, please make sure to hit the like button in order to let the YouTube algorithm know that you loved the video. And for more such insightful business and political case studies, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you on Tuesday. Bye-bye.